Is liberty dying where you live? Escape to Keene at freekeene.com.
Do they have a counsel?
They have a counsel. It's Mr. Hynes.
Mr. Bradbury, MacKinnon and Lilley.
Yes.
Thank you.
I assume that both people will be together.
Yes, I spoke with the state and they don't have any objection. I'll leave up to the court.
Ladies, if you come forward, please, you can take a seat. I just want to sort of preliminarily see where we're at. Mr. Bradbury.
Good morning, Your
Honor. Mr. Bradbury, I have to confess that I did not have a chance to read your objection. I was here yesterday and reviewed counsel's motion to dismiss. As I look at least the motion to dismiss, it's a well thought out, sequentially addressed motion in sort of multi-levels in terms of equal protection, statutory authority and jurisdiction. And I can't remember the other. I thought there were four categories in which you were desirous of motions to dismiss. Mr. Bradbury, let me swing to you. Is this a case that needs an evidentiary hearing to the extent that the court needs the case in chief heard in order to rule on the two motions to dismiss? I mean, it seems, I'm just thinking that the facts are pretty basic.
The facts are pretty basic. Yeah. We have agreed to stipulate to multiple items in this matter.
All right.
However, I would still intend to have three witnesses testify.
All right.
And perhaps the two officers that were involved in the matter.
Okay.
And I would respectfully request an opportunity for a closing argument.
Okay. All right. Mr. Hynes, what's your thought?
I believe the First Amendment issue is one that would probably need facts from both the state and probably the defense. I think the other issues are more of legal, that the facts could be stipulated, but the fact that, I mean, at least one of the arguments would require that, and I guess the state's prepared to go forward. If we're not objecting to that, we would, I guess, leave it up to the court.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to order you not to have the trial. Certainly beyond my authority to do that. So, we have another matter in front of you, and we'll get to you as soon as we can.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Heidi Lilley and MacKinnon.
Heidi Lilley and Barbara MacKinnon.
So I think this is final decision.
Okay.
That's done. I'm sentencing on the one I am guilty of.
Yeah, you can just take that third chair.
I certainly can.
Counsel, the court is in receipt of your motion and the state's objection. Court will deal with that after the presentation of evidence with a written order.
Thank you.
And anything else preliminarily, counsel?
There's a few stipulations the state can address.
Dave?
Yes, Paul.
Again, we've agreed to stipulate to defendant's ID.
Good.
To the defendant's being topless.
Mm-hmm.
On town property. And the beach regulation. Chapter 3, town beach regulations. With the exception of female topless sunbathing. Shorthand.
Okay. Here, if I inadvertently refer to the town beach property ordinance as town ordinance or statute, that is what I refer to.
That's fine.
Thank you.
All right, state, ready to go?
No, I am. I also have three exhibits already pre-marked.
Okay, and are they admitted by agreement?
Yeah.
All right, Mr. Bradbury, you can apply your first witness.
If parties have not been sequestered, I'd ask that they be stepped out now. And I will call Melanie Diagata first.
Okay. Yeah. Mr. Gatta?
Yeah.
Any other witnesses, just step out.
Morning, ma'am.
I think
it's still morning.
Really?
Raise your right hand. You solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give this court to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you.
I do.
Please be seated. State your first and last name. Spell your last name.
My name is Melanie Daga, D'Agata.
Okay. Go ahead, Mr. Bradbury.
Thank you. Ms. Daga, where do you live?
Gilford.
And how long have you lived in Gilford?
About 17 years.
Drawing your attention to September 6, 2015, approximately 4:51 p.m., do you recall where you were?
Yes.
Where were you?
At Gilford Beach.
Okay. Were you there alone?
I was there with my 9-year-old daughter.
Okay. At or about that time, did something happen that required you or led you to speak to the police?
Yes.
Could you please explain?
Yep. I am familiar with lots of the families that go to Gilford Beach, and I noticed some commotion within a family next to us. I noticed a group of kids in the back who seemed really upset. At the time, I hadn't seen what was going on, but based on the commotion, I began to look around and I saw two groups of women, topless, a few on the beach in between the snack shack and the raft, and then a group of women standing topless in between the shoreline and the raft where most of the kids play at that time because there's no lifeguards on duty and there were lots of kids on the raft.
And what was your immediate reaction?
I was, I guess, more offended for the kids because the kids seemed so upset. There were some coming out of the water, some just making comments to their parents, and I was aware that this group was going to be at Weir's Beach for the day, so I was a little bit shocked that they used Gilford Beach as their platform.
Okay. And why were you shocked that they were at Gilford Beach?
Because Gilford Beach is a small private beach only frequented by taxpayers. Normally, there's someone at the gate prior to Labor Day that checks to make sure you have a town pass.
Okay. And you said that you were there with a child of your own?
Yes.
Okay. And what was your child's reaction?
She actually came running out of the water and said, "Mom, I have an emergency." And she was pointing to the women on the beach.
Okay. And the women that were on the beach are present in courtroom today?
Two of them.
Okay. Thank you. Now, based upon your observations, what, if anything, did you do?
I went over to the women that were standing in the water. They appeared to me that they were not just there trying to enjoy the day at the beach. Some of them had their hands on their hips, almost like they were trying to get some attention. So I approached them. I said, "Do any of you pay taxes here?" And a response I got from one of the women was no. I then asked, "Do you realize this is a private beach and nudity is not allowed?" And someone responded, "We're not nude." And I said, "Well, the group of 12-year-old boys over there that are requesting you get dressed believe you are nude." And they said, "This is legal." I said, "Okay, we'll let the police decide." And then one of them started to just kind of spout off. I just put my hand up and walked away.
Okay. Did you call the police department?
Yes.
Okay. And you reported the incident to the police?
Mm-hmm.
And the police did respond?
They did.
Okay. And did you have any contact with the women other than that?
Commenting back and forth on the news articles online, yes.
Okay. Post incident?
Yes.
Okay. Right. Now, did you take photographs?
I did.
Okay. And you provided those to the state?
Yes.
To me? Right. Your Honor, those would be the two images submitted, states 1 and 2.
All right.
Thank you.
And you guys agreed that she took those photographs?
I don't know who's talking about, I have no objection to them being admitted.
Okay. One and two.
Thank you.
Did you pre-mark the photographs?
I did pre-mark them. All right.
Gotcha. All right. One and two.
Thank you. Are you familiar with the Town Beach regulations?
Yes.
Okay. And specifically with respect to female topless sunbathing?
Mm-hmm.
And just so we're clear, they were topless. They did have bottoms on, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Have you spoken to anyone since this incident? Families that you know or anything?
Yes, many, many family members, yeah.
All right. And what's...
I'm sorry.
What is their position?
That it's absolutely inappropriate.
Yeah, just like that. So, Bradford.
That's right. Nothing further.
Okay. Counsel, any questions?
Yes.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
So you were immediately concerned that day?
As soon as I realized what all the commotion was about.
And did them being bare-chested, did that offend you?
No, actually I'm a nurse, so I see people bare-chested every day.
So you were looking out for the children?
Yes, I was upset about their reaction.
Did you have contact with those children?
Yes.
And they told you that they were nude, or that they saw nude people?
Yes, I mean, there was a commotion and then lots of them were pointing and, yes.
Did you explain to them, no one's nude here?
No, actually, because we teach them as, I worked at Gilford Elementary School for 10 years, so I'm very familiar with all the kids that were at the beach, and there's a dress code at school, so the girls are not allowed to wear spaghetti straps because they consider it inappropriate. So then how do you send them to the beach with nude women and tell them that it is appropriate?
Were there nude women at the beach?
In my definition, yes. They were topless. To me, breasts are sexual. When you're topless, you're nude.
If I were topless on that beach, would I be nude?
Nope.
Do you teach your 9-year-old daughter that female bearing your chest are nude?
Yeah.
Do you recall who you spoke to about whether they paid taxes there?
I don't, but was it a large group of women, maybe 6 in the water? I directed the question at the group, and I believe I got one response, which was no. And I'm not sure that Heidi Lilley was part of that group in the water. She may have been understanding.
All right. And do you teach your daughter that when she grows up, she can be anything she wants?
I teach my daughter if she wants to be equal to men, she can do it in such a way with education and her hard work as opposed to showing body parts.
So you're essentially telling her it's wrong for her to be in public, your daughter, without a top on?
Yeah. I would not want my daughter in public without her top on.
How do you determine who's female?
I guess they have breasts and no penis.
Are you aware everyone there that they had bottoms on?
I'm sorry?
Everyone that you saw at the beach that day at least had some form of bottom on?
Yes.
If someone, if a woman had a double mastectomy, would you be okay with her being in public without a shirt on?
I guess I never really considered, but in that case, yes, because it would be more of an experience and less of...
Yes, you would still object.
No, I wouldn't object because to me, it was Gilford Beach was being used as a platform to prove a point. It wasn't just women coming to enjoy the day at the beach.
And to prove that point, is that female equality?
Not in my opinion.
Well, what point do you think they were trying to prove?
Oh, you're asking if they were trying to prove the point of female equality? Yes, I do.
So you take offense with people trying to promote female equality?
Absolutely not. I take offense with people using a very small town private beach, which is an extension of our homes, which has children visiting week after week after week, year after year, for 17 years that I've gone to Gilford Beach. So I have a problem with people choosing that place as their platform for something that is not societal norms. Weir's Beach, fine. Hampton Beach, fine. I don't know what I'm going to see when I take my kids there. It's a public beach. This was our backyard. It might as well have been the soccer field. It might as well have been the pickup loop at the elementary school. In my opinion, it was an inappropriate setting.
Were there men at that beach where that
Yes.
church was on?
Yeah.
Were you okay with that?
Yeah. Because that's the societal norm. That's what our kids expect to see when they go to Gilford Beach. It's what they've seen every year.
If two people of the same sex were kissing on the beach, would that be offensive?
No.
Because society's come away, now that's okay?
In my opinion.
Thank you, nothing further.
Mr. Bradbury, anything further?
Nothing further, thank you.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it. State?
State calls Aaron DeMers.
Your Honor, we would ask that the witness remain just possible identifications for.
Yep.
If you come up to the witness box. It's a slight ramp, so. And remain standing, raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give this court be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth itself?
Yes.
Please be seated. Say your first and last name for the court. Spelling your last name.
It's Aaron Demers, D-E-M-E-R-S.
Okay. Mr. Bradford.
Thank you, Robert. Good morning, Mr. Mercer.
Morning.
Where do you live?
Gilford.
You're a Gilford resident?
Yes.
How long have you been a sophomore?
9 years.
Thank you. Drawing your attention to September 6, 2015, at approximately 4:51 in the afternoon.
Yes.
Do you recall where you were?
Gilford Beach.
Okay. And were you there alone?
No.
Who were you there with?
Son and husband.
Okay. How old is your son?
He's 13.
Okay. And did something occur at or about that time that led you to speak to the police?
Yeah, we had women walking around with no tops on.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what drew your attention to that?
My husband came and told me.
Okay. In relationship to the beach, where were you at the time?
I was in the, when they first took the tops off, I was in the truck.
In the truck?
Yeah.
In the parking lot?
Yes.
Okay. And your husband came to you at the truck?
Yeah.
And you, what did you do in response?
And I said, no way, that's not happening. And I walked down and it was,
okay.
So.
All right, what was your immediate reaction?
Shock, anger, a lot of anger.
Did you say anything to anybody?
I did,
okay.
And I said that they needed to put on clothes, and I said that, you know, my son is here. They said they were messed up.
Where was your son at the time?
He actually had swam down, because my husband said go that way. He had swam down and got out and was down far enough that he didn't see anything. So he, thankfully, yeah.
Okay. Now, you're saying in court, and I apologize, I can tell you you're nervous.
Thanks.
Me too.
You said that they needed to close on. Was that in those words?
No. I said, hey, put your expletive away.
And were you calm like that, or were you?
No.
You were very vocal?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Because that was your immediate reaction?
Right.
Okay. Did they respond to you?
Yes, that this was natural and legal.
Did you have any further conversation with them?
Just what I said. You know, my son is here, the kids are here. This can't be legal.
And you've been a resident for 9 years?
Right.
Have you gone to Gilford Beach every year?
Yes.
And can you describe Gilford Beach?
It's beautiful. It's the reason we bought in Gilford. our realtor brought us to the beach and we thought, Gilford's good. And no longer, I won't go if that's happening. My son won't go.
Is it a family beach?
Yes.
Okay. In the past, have you allowed your son to go there by himself?
No.
How old is your son?
He's 13.
Okay. All right. Did you call the police?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, just because they stated it was legal, and I said, there's no way. So I was really just calling to find out.
Okay. And did Gilford police officers respond?
Yes.
Okay. Did they meet with you?
No. No, we left.
Okay, you had left at that point?
Right.
But at some point in time, did somebody speak to you regarding this?
Well, I was subpoenaed. I talked to the girl on the phone at the police station.
Okay.
But other than that, no.
Other than that, no. Okay. All right. No further questions.
Okay.
Don't. Hold on. He gets
asked. You're still here.
Thank you. Your son's 13?
Yes.
And did you see any men on the beach that day without their shirt on?
Yes.
Did that upset you?
No, sir.
Why not?
Because it's a man.
If there was a young girl on the fish beach without a shirt on, would that upset you?
What can you define young?
There was a female under the age of 5 on the shirt on the beach without her shirt on. Would that upset you?
I think it would, yes.
If there was a breast cancer survivor who had a double mastectomy on the beach, would that offend you?
Yes.
If she didn't have a shirt?
It would.
How do you know who's female?
I guess because it's obvious who's female and who's male.
Based on their chest?
Based on their sex.
So it's obvious if they're female based on their sex.
Correct.
Did you confront the people on the beach that day?
Yeah.
Didn't have shirts on? Were you yelling at them?
No.
You said you were angry?
Yes.
How close did you have a conversation with them?
A little bit of a conversation.
Did you ever point your fingers at them?
No.
Your testimony was you told them, hey, put your expletive away. It's fair to say you weren't calm.
Correct.
Were you causing a scene?
No.
When you said you thought there was no way their conduct, or you said there was no way you believe their conduct was legal, correct?
Correct.
And you called the police about that?
Right.
And did they talk to you about the conduct, how it might be illegal?
Yes, she did. She said there was an ordinance that you couldn't be nude at the beach.
All right. So, to your knowledge, they could be topless on the sidewalks outside of the beach in Gilford?
I have no knowledge of that, no.
If that were true, would that make you want to leave Gilford?
If that were true, where they could walk around Gilford without a top on, would it make me want to leave the... Right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. It would.
If the state of New Hampshire said it was legal for a female to be topless, would that make you want to leave the state?
It would.
Thank you. Nothing further.
Just one follow-up.
Sure.
Defense was inquiring about a young female being on the beach. If you saw a 14-year-old female on the beach without a top on, would you be offended by that?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Good. Mr. Hynes?
Nothing further.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
And I think the instruction is that you're going to hang around and get a little bit longer.
The state calls Robert Landry.
State, can you spell the first witness's name again?
Melody.
Yeah.
Last name is Dega. D apostrophe A T T A.
In my school, it was Degada. Tony Degada. Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give the court be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you?
Do.
Welcome, Mr. Landry. Have a seat. State your first and last name. Spell me your last name.
Robert Landry, L-A-N-D-R-Y.
Okay. State.
Good afternoon, Mr. Landry.
Are you a Gilford resident?
Yes, I am.
Where do you live?
In Gilford.
How long have you been
able to... If there was ever a circular question, that was had to be it.
So I have to ask the questions. I don't want to
know. Do you need an exact address?
That's right.
No.
That's
okay. Right. How long have you been a Gilford resident?
Since 1958.
You're familiar with Gilford Beach?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Drawing your attention to September 6th, 2015 at 4:51 in the afternoon, do you recall where you were?
At Gilford Beach.
Thank you. And did something happen at or about that time that caused you to speak to the police or contact the police?
Yeah, when I was here, I observed, I don't know the exact number, but several women topless.
Okay. And whereabouts were they located on the beach?
Half were in the water and half were out of the water.
Do you have any conversations with anybody regarding them?
No, I did not.
Okay. What was your immediate reaction?
That it wasn't the place for these ladies to be here at the public, at our beach, you know, Gilford Beach. Kids, families, I felt it was wrong, so that's why I called police.
Okay. And did the police officers respond?
Yes, they did.
Were you there when the police officers responded?
Yes, I was.
Did officers talk to you?
No, they did not.
Did you have conversations with any of the females?
No, I did not.
And just so we're clear, they were topless, however, they had bottoms on at the time.
Yes, sir.
And you're familiar with the Gilford Town Ordinance concerning Gilford Beach? Are you?
I couldn't say verbatim, but I know it's, you know, no drinking alcohol in public and no nudity.
Nothing further, thank you.
Okay. Ms. Hines?
Thank you. When you say no nudity, you agree everyone there had some form of bottom on, correct?
Had some form of bottom on?
They were not naked. They had clothing on their bottom half.
Most people did, except for the young women that they're topless.
Correct. All right. So from someone's belly button downwards, all the women there had some form of clothing on, correct?
Correct.
Were the women harassing anyone?
Not that I noticed.
Thank you. Nothing further.
Okay. State?
Nothing further.
Thank you, Mr. Landry. Is Mr. Landry free to go?
Yes, I don't anticipate any.
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Landry, thanks a lot. State, next witness.
State will call Sergeant Corey O'Connor.
Okay. Come over here to the witness stand. And remain standing. Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give this court be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you? Please be seated. State your first and last name for the court, spelling your last name. Corey O'Connor, O'Connor.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Sergeant O'Connor.
Good afternoon.
How are you employed?
I'm employed as a full-time patrol sergeant with the town of Gilford.
How long have you been so employed?
It'll be 14 years in February.
And where do you live?
I live in Gilford.
How long have you lived in Gilford?
I moved to Gilford in 1980.
You're familiar with Gilford Beach?
Yes.
Are you familiar with the regulations for Gilford Beach?
Most of them.
Okay. Thank you. Drawing your attention to September 6, 2015 at 4:51 in the afternoon, were you on duty for Gilford Police Department?
I was.
At or about that time, were you assigned to investigate an incident?
I was.
Okay. Could you please describe what the nature of that incident was?
I was assigned to respond to the Gilford Beach for the report of several women who were topless.
Okay. And was it reported as such?
Yes.
And did you respond to the beach?
I did.
Okay. And while you responded to the beach, did you receive any updates as to the status of the situation?
There was a couple of complaints that came in as we were responding there.
Okay. And what was the nature of those complaints as well?
Just reports that the women were there topless.
Okay. Did you arrive at Gilford Beach?
I did.
Okay. When you arrived, did you make any observations?
Yes, as we pulled in, there was two of us there. As I walked in, I saw the two females topless walking over to the snack center.
Okay. And did you hear any anything?
I heard some heckling. There was a couple, I was approached by another, a parent had pulled up and made a comment that their son was there. They were there to pick up their son because they were told there was females at the beach that were topless.
And as you were responding or prior to responding, did you contact anyone with respect to Gilford Beach?
I contacted dispatch to talk to Herb Green, who is the rec director for the town, to inquire about the ordinance or if there was any ordinance against the topless females at the beach.
Okay. And was that confirmed for you?
Yes, there was. We actually confirmed it ourselves. By looking into the ordinance for the town.
And as you approached the playground area, did you make any observations of anyone that you recognized?
Yes, I observed Heidi Lilley with another female, like I said, walking over near the snack, by the side of where the snack center and the bathrooms are on the right-hand side.
Okay. And what was the status of their attire?
They were both topless, exposing their breasts. Heidi had a pair of shorts on and the other woman had a bikini bottom on.
Okay. Did you make contact with them?
Yes, I did.
And did you have a conversation with them?
Yes, I spoke with them and I explained that there was an ordinance against the, you know, being topless at the beach. At that point, I had seen there was a few other females over near the center of the beach that were also topless. At that point, we all walked over and talked as a group.
Okay. And what was the nature of that conversation?
I explained all of them. There was the ordinance against the topless sunbathing. I offered them to put on their tops and said they were welcome to stay at the beach because Heidi's a resident and you know, they were guests of hers. At that point, some began to question the ordinance. I explained that, you know, if they didn't want to put on their tops, then they'd be cited for the ordinance violation. And then if they still didn't want to comply to that, then they'd be asked to leave the beach.
And did all the parties comply and put on tops?
Yes, most of them all did right away. Ms. MacKinnon stood topless for a little bit longer while we discussed it. And then when we decided that they were going to be cited, then she complied and put her top on.
Okay. And are the defendants present in the courtroom?
Yes, they are. They're at the defense table.
Thank you.
The record will reflect that the officers identified Ms. Lilley and Ms. MacKinnon.
Thank you. Did you serve summonses?
Yes, we did.
And were they explained to both parties?
Yes.
Okay. Did they have any questions?
No, not at the time.
Okay. Did they make any statements with respect to charges?
Ms. Lilley spoke, you know, briefly about it, how she didn't feel that she felt it was a rights violation and that she'd be, you know, fighting the ticket.
When you were returning to your cruiser, fill up the summons. Were you approached by anybody?
That's when I was approached by another parent that had kind of pulled in fast next to my cruiser, jumped out, and she said that, you know, that she heard there was a topless woman at the beach, and she was her son. Okay.
And what was her demeanor?
She appeared like she was in a panic.
Nothing further.
Okay. Mr. Hines, questions for Sergeant O'Connor?
Thank you. Sergeant Cogney graduated from Police Academy.
Yes, I did.
And in this case, you wrote police reports?
Yes.
And it's fair to say your police report is complete and accurate?
Correct.
In your report, you wrote, I told the women that I understood and was aware of what they were doing as far as the Free the Nipple event, correct?
Correct.
What was your understanding of the Free the Nipple event?
I read about it a little bit in the news and had seen some other things as far as, I believe, Hampton or Old Orchard Beach. And then one of the callers, when they called in, addressed it as they were freeing their nipples down at the beach.
So it's fair to say one of those callers was also aware of the Free the Nipple movement or campaign or event?
Yes, so it's exactly fair to say that.
And to your understanding, is that movement for gender equality?
From what I understand, yes.
And so you're aware, or were aware, that Ms. Lilley was a resident of Gilford?
Yes, I'm familiar with her.
All right. And if she had a shirt on, she would have been fine, correct?
If she had a shirt on at the beach?
Yes.
Yes.
And if she were a male without a shirt, that also would have been okay?
Yes.
If she stepped off the beach and was in downtown Gilford on the sidewalks without a shirt, would that be okay?
Maybe something we would address, but that wasn't the nature of the complaint at the time.
All right. To your knowledge, does Gilford have any town ordinance that prohibits swimming from being bare-chested in public, not on the beach?
Not to my knowledge, no.
And were the women polite?
Yes.
It's fair to say there were no riots?
No.
Thank you. Nothing further.
State?
Nothing further.
Okay. Thank you, Sergeant.
Thank you.
Sergeant, free to go?
Yes, yes, sir.
Thank you. State, next witness.
So call Officer Andrew Kim.
Sergeant O'Connor, could you get the other officer when you want that?
Yes.
Solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give this court be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help you?
Yes, sir, I do.
Please be seated. State your first and last name for the court, spelling your last name.
It's Officer Andrew Salmon, SALMON.
State.
Good afternoon, Officer Salmon. How are you employed?
I'm currently employed full time with Gilford Police Department.
Were you previously employed by another agency?
I was, the Tilden Police Department, for 9.5 years.
How long have you been a certified police officer?
On 10 years, sir.
Thank you. Drawing your attention to September 6, 2015 at 4:51 in the afternoon, were you on duty?
Yes, sir, I was.
At or about that time, were you assigned to investigate a call?
I was.
What was the nature of the call?
It was a report of topless sunbathers at the Gilford Beach.
Did you respond to that call?
I did.
Did you make contact with anyone?
I did.
Who did you make contact with?
There was two females, subject by the name of Heidi Lilley and Carrie Stevens.
And is Heidi Lilley from the employment?
She is. See that defense counsel in a purple sweater.
The record will reflect the officers identified Ms. Lilley.
Thank you. And what was the nature of their strike down? You made contact with them?
We did.
And were they wearing tops?
They were not.
Okay. Did you have a conversation with them?
I personally did not.
You did not? You were just a secondary officer?
I was.
Did you make any observations as to anyone else on the beach not related or not included with Miss Heidi Lilley's group?
I didn't, personally, no.
I'm not sure I understand that question.
Yeah. Outside of Miss Lilley's group, did he make any observations of anyone on the beach?
Okay.
He did not.
Right.
Nothing.
All right. Mr. Hines?
Thank you. Approximately how many women were on the beach that day topless?
I would say 6 to 8.
And were those women at all times respectful with you?
They were.
And how do you determine who's female?
How did I determine who was female?
Yeah.
By their exposed breasts.
If I were on the beach without a shirt on, would I be in violation of the town beach ordinance?
Not how that ordinance reads, no.
Because I'm not female?
Correct.
Someone had a double mastectomy and was on that beach, and they're female, would they be in violation of the statute?
Technically, yes.
Would a mother whose breastfeeding be in violation of the statute if her breast became exposed?
On that beach?
On that beach.
Technically, yes.
It's fair to say the defendant's conduct, if they were male or otherwise not female, would have been lawful.
Correct.
Thank you. Nothing further.
Just one call. Is there a difference between a female topless sunbathing and a female breastfeeding a child?
I would say.
And what is that difference?
I would say that the mother that's breastfeeding is there to feed her child. Sunbathing is topless, just sunbathing.
Thank you. Thank you, Officer Sandy. You step in.
You're on the stay, Rod.
Stay, Rod.
Officer Sandy, can you excuse me?
Officer Sandy, you're free to go.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Your Honor, the defense will move to dismiss for the reasons stated in the motion to dismiss. My understanding the court will continue, allow continuation of the trial and make consideration for the record's clear hand.
Not a problem.
Thank you.
The court will reserve the motion to dismiss based on your pleadings before the court. The court will note for the record that the state has responded to the defendant's motion to dismiss, and the court reserves the right to make a determination as to that. So, with that in mind, counsel, do you have witnesses?
Yes, the defense would call Lord John Heller.
Laura Drumheller, Drumheller.
Counsel?
Thank you. Ms. Drumheller, on Sunday, September 6th, were you at the beach in Gilford?
Yes.
And in this case, some witnesses testified, and they are standing in the back of the courtroom. Can you identify any of those witnesses?
Yes, the woman in the black, I recognize.
On our left?
Yes.
Okay. And I would ask that the court take notice that...
The court will recognize that the witness has identified Ms. Demers, I believe.
Correct. Thank you. And did you have contact with her that day?
Yes.
You can send a message. And what did your contact with her entail?
I was over at my blanket putting on sunscreen. She came up to me. She got pretty close to my face. And the contact mostly consisted of her just yelling at me. I didn't really say much. I didn't really know what to say. She was kind of attacking me a little bit, calling me names, swearing. I didn't feel like physically threatened, but, you know, she was definitely very aggravated. She said I was like mentally unstable and some things along those lines. And yeah, that's kind of how it went.
Is it fair to say she wasn't calm?
No, she was not calm.
Do you recall any of the names she called you?
Whore and, slut, stuff like that. And, the whole thing about, saying, mentally stable, sane person would do this. Like, you know, you must have had, a bad childhood or something that you're, that you are this way. Like I was, something wrong with me that I would be topless on the beach.
Thank you. Nothing further.
State.
Good afternoon, Mr. Hall. Are you a resident of Gilford?
No.
Where do you reside?
In Greenfield, Massachusetts.
Okay. Who were your guests over that day?
Heidi Lilley.
Right. Were you wearing a top that day?
No.
What was your purpose of being at Gilford Beach?
Just to relax, have fun. We started at Ware's Beach, but they cleared the beach to do fireworks. So we decided to go to Gilford so we could swim a little longer.
Okay. What was your purpose of being at Greer's Beach?
The same thing, to swim, sunbathe, hang out with friends, have snacks.
Was it part of a political expression?
It is part of a movement, but really, it's comfortable to be topless on a hot day at the beach. It's freeing, it feels nice. Less tan lines. I don't personally really care about tan lines, but it wasn't necessarily entirely political.
At Weir's Beach or at Gilford Beach?
No. We weren't going around. We didn't have signs. We weren't, shouting or, trying to, promote our cause. We were just there, relaxing, trying to show people that we can be topless and the world's not going to end. We're just enjoying a day at the beach. Nothing unusual.
Okay. Were you aware of the town ordinance prior to going to Gilford Beach?
No, I was not.
At the front.
You can ask a couple more questions. Are you either a member of or associate or support the Free the Nipple movement?
Yes.
All right. And can you explain what that movement is or is about?
What that movement is basically, at the surface, it's just, equal rights where in any place where a man can remove his top, like a park or the beach, downtown, walking on the streets, we want women to have the same right. Certainly, we're not trying to, get to do that in restaurants or anything like that. But on a greater level, it's really just about, there's, this slut-shaming culture and rape culture and all of this stuff. And it's people always ask, what was she wearing or things like that. And just, we're trying to normalize it and desexualize the breast. I think that's kind of what it's about, at least for me, just desexualizing it, unless we want them to be sexual, but just they're not inherently sexual. Just a topless woman on the beach or a topless man on the beach, there's some very good looking male chests, that people might like to look at, but there's nothing inherently sexual about that, so.
Thank you. Did you see any of the topless women engaging in any sexual contact with their chest?
No. rubbing on some sunscreen, that's about as much touching as I saw.
Thank you. And you said part of your ultimate goal or hope is to normalize this behavior?
Yeah.
So is it fair to say you don't want to draw attention, unneeded or unwarranted attention to yourself?
Yeah, we don't want to make it like a huge spectacle. It is unusual, so people do stare and people do say things and they ask, is this legal? And it is, in a lot of places in this state legal. And people are shocked, they don't even know that, a lot of them.
Right. Thank you, nothing for that.
Is it legal to walk down the street without a top on?
In New Hampshire, I think.
Why don't you do that?
I have walked around in New Hampshire topless before.
In Gilford?
No, not before that day. I hadn't.
Where have you?
Always have a moment. I mean, specifically, we're talking about Gilford regulations and.
Your Honor. Part of the state's argument is societal standards. And okay. That's where it goes to, Your Honor.
All right, go ahead.
Mostly on like the beach, near Hampton, Northampton, that whole area. I've walked topless through like the towns and on the beach. That's predominantly where I've been topless.
So is it fair to say that during beach outings?
Yeah.
But not normal, everyday, day-to-day life?
Not generally.
Why not everyday?
I mean, you don't see a lot of men walking around topless on Main Street. Occasionally you see it, and that's a little weird too. I mean, it's not super common, on, you know, but it's just a comfort thing. At the beach, I like to be comfortable. I don't find bathing suit tops very comfortable. They don't fit me very well. Like, you get, like, they dig in. It's not, you know, but walking downtown where I can just wear whatever clothes I find comfortable, I don't really feel the need to be topless there, personally.
Thank you.
Nothing further.
Thank you. Can you them? Counsel?
Here at the defense would call Heidi Lilley to stand.
Yep. Ms. Lilley? One. Second. Ms. Lilley, raise your right hand. You solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give this court to be the truth. Please be seated. State your first and last name for the court. Spelling your last name.
Heidi Lilley, L-I-L-L-E-Y.
All right, counsel.
Thank you. Heidi, what town do you live in?
Gilford.
All right. And were you at the Gilford Beach Sunday, September 6th?
Yes.
And while you were at that beach, at any point, was your chest exposed?
Yes.
And why was your chest exposed?
I guess the long and the short answer is comfort. Free the nipple, many reasons.
And I'll ask a little more direct question. Are you a member of or otherwise support the cause of the Free the Nipple campaign?
Sure.
And what does that campaign mean to you personally?
It means a lot to me. It's a, I guess, simple answer is equality for men and women. For me, it's a lot about rape culture, it's about body shaming, it's about slut shaming, it's about a lot of things. But it's primarily about equality in all forms, not just the body.
Thank you. And do you feel this ordinance treats you differently than it treats men?
Yes.
Were you engaged in sexual activity that day?
At the beach?
On the beach?
No.
Besides the Gilford Beach, have you been topless in other places in New Hampshire?
Many.
Is it only beaches or other places?
Other places.
Are any of those places in public?
Yes.
Could you give us some examples?
Lock Hill, Mount Catarvan, Hampton Beach, Mount Cardigan, Knowles Hill Road in Alexandria, Laconia, several others.
All right, thank you. Nothing further.
Okay. State?
You say it's about body equality.
Body equality.
When you went to Gilford Beach that day, were you aware of the town ordinance?
No, I wasn't.
Did you intend on going to Gilford Beach that day?
I had no intentions initially of going to Gilford Beach, no.
Okay. Why did you end up going to Gilford Beach?
We started out at Rears Beach, actually to fight the ordinance in Laconia, and we moved to Rears to Gilford because they closed down Rears Beach because they were setting up for fireworks, and it was hot. My friends were from out of state, and we didn't want to end the day at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, so we decided, let's go to Gilford Beach, because I knew that Gilford had no town ordinance for toplessness. So I said, let's go to Gilford Beach. I'm a resident. Let's go there. And as a matter of fact, the first thing I did when I got to the beach was looked at the sign, and it does not have no toplessness. It says no nude sunbathing, but it does not have no toplessness. So I said, we're clothed.
So you said you knew that Gilford did not have any town ordinance?
Right.
So you had looked into it before?
I had.
Okay. When you were at Weir's Beach, that was a political statement?
Yes.
What was the question?
When she was at Weir's Beach, that was a political statement or expression?
Yes.
So when you went to Gilford Beach, was that a political...
It was carrying on, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Even though there's no town ordinance, but it is?
It's, I'm always making a political statement when I'm topless, yes.
Mr. Hynes?
Is part of that political statement what you said you wanted to be normalized for females to be topless?
Yes.
And to essentially desexualize female chest or breasts?
Yes.
Thank you. Nothing further. Okay.
Alright. May I step down?
And you're on the defense would call Barbara MacKinnon.
Okay. Mr. MacKinnon? Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give in this court is the truth, all the truth, and nothing but the truth to help you? Please be seated. You state your first and last name to the court, spelling your last name.
Barbara MacKinnon, M-A-C, capital K-I-N-N-O-N.
Thank you. Ms. MacKinnon, do you recall being at the Gilford Beach on Sunday, September 6, 2015?
I do.
And were you there that day with Ms. Lilley?
I was.
All right. Were you essentially a guest of hers at the beach? Or?
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah.
And are you either a member of or support the Free the Nipple movement?
I do.
And what does that movement mean to you?
My interest is a little bit different from a lot of the other members. I'm neither a breastfeeding parent nor a woman. So my interest in normalizing toplessness for people with breasts is largely to fight the distinction that is imposed upon me by my body.
All right. And when you say you're not a woman, could you expand on that?
Sure. I identify as transgender. I'm non-binary. So I don't identify as either a man or a woman. And having laws for women inflicted upon me is inaccurate.
All right. And I know a lot of people use different language. Would you also then say you're not male or female, or I guess could you use?
I would say I'm neither male nor female.
And you said this is part of your gender, how you identify?
Correct. The day had begun as a political statement. At that point in the afternoon, it was very, very hot, and I largely just wanted to get in the water.
All
So yes and no, I guess.
Okay. Were you there spreading the, promoting free the nipple?
We certainly weren't proselytizing or talking to strangers, but our presence alone certainly promotes the movement, absolutely.
By drawing attention?
By being visible.
Now, excuse me if I'm incorrect, you indicated you're non-binary?
Correct.
Okay. By societal standards, is it fair to say that you have breasts?
Correct.
Were you born with a penis?
I was not.
You were born with a vagina?
I was.
Okay. Right. So, by societal standards, society would identify you as a female?
I was assigned female on birth, yes.
All right.
Counsel?
Thank you, nothing further.
Okay, thank you very much. Counsel?
Yeah, the defense rests if I could have a brief oral argument.
Sure.
Dismiss. As the court's aware, so we're making a motion to dismiss essentially 4 points, two of them being constitutional, that being equal protection violation and First Amendment violation. And I've seen the state's response, and I take exception to the state's response saying that those are subject to heightened scrutiny. So I would agree under the federal constitution, at least the gender discrimination, equal protection violation, that one would be subject to heightened scrutiny. But I believe New Hampshire has taken it a step further, actually, and when it's either a fundamental right, which I suggest the First Amendment is, or when it's based on gender, then that's subject to strict scrutiny. Specifically, paragraph 7 of my brief discusses that an equal protection challenge must determine appropriate standard of review, strict scrutiny, fair a rational basis, heightened scrutiny, and that they look to gender as one of those suspect classifications. We apply a strict scrutiny test in which government must show a compelling state interest when the classification involves a suspect class based on race, creed, color, gender, national origin, or legitimacy. I suggest that sex and gender may very well be different. There's some testimony in this case as to what that difference will be, but I suggest under the statute, in interpretation, legally, those are essentially the same thing. So I suggest under the state constitution, our Supreme Court is giving that strict scrutiny. That's essentially the nail in the coffin for this state. As your Honor is aware, very, very, very few ordinances, statutes can withstand that extremely high scrutiny. If the court were to even give it the heightened scrutiny that the state is advancing, I suggest they can't even meet that burden. I'm not sure exactly what goal the state is seeking, but I believe they addressed it in their brief in paragraph, it's like 16 addresses part of it. Essentially, I expect they're relying something on, hey, it's a safety issue, moral issue, ethical issue, whatever they're relying on. The legislature has expressly gone the opposite way on that. RSA 354A, the statute dealing with the Human Rights Commission, essentially the law against discrimination, it makes specific references and says the complete opposite of what the state is trying to advance this case. So I suggest that that might be their interest. The legislature has taken the opposite view, expressly said, no, it's so important that people are being treated fairly and equally based on their gender. So I don't even think the state should be allowed to argue that point when it's prohibited by statute. In regards to the town ordinance, as your Honor, I believe, is aware, New Hampshire is not a home state rule in that the towns need permission from the state legislature to address these issues. New Hampshire state law specifically does not prohibit women or females from being in public topless. It looks like the town of Gilford in the town does not prohibit it, but prohibits it on the beach. I think that further cuts into their argument that, hey, this is a really important issue and we need to protect people. Going back to the 354A1, law against discrimination, it shall be deemed an exercise of the police power of the state for the protection of the public welfare, health and peace of the people of the state in fulfillment of the provisions of the Constitution of the state concerning civil rights. The court, general court, finds and declares practices of discrimination against any of its inhabitants because of age, sex, race, creed, color, marital status, family, familial status, physical or mental disability, or national origin, or a matter of state concern, that such discrimination not only threatens the rights and proper privileges of its inhabitants, but menaces the institutions and foundation of a free democratic society, and threatens the peace, order, health, safety, and general welfare of the state and its inhabitants. In this case, people objecting to it, I think that's the problem here. Certainly, people have a right to honestly express their discontent with someone, but this is essentially a heckler's veto. We don't live in a society where people can say, I don't like that, you can't do it, especially when these things relate to someone's gender or sex. In regards to the civil rights movement, whether it be race, gender, or marriage equality, this country has come a long distance. Only barely 100 years ago, women were given the right to vote. This past year, the U.S. Supreme Court expanded same-sex marriage and marriage equality. Those are important things. Courts are recognizing that if you are going to discriminate based on someone for sex and gender, you better have a very good reason, and we're going to subject to really scrutiny in that regard. Looking at the gay rights movement, I suggest that, hey, 20 years ago, if people of the same sex were walking down hand in hand in the street, a lot of people might get offended by that. If they kiss, people might be really outraged about that. That's not the level that the statute that deals with gender discrimination in the First Amendment, that's not the level that we apply to these things. The defendants are essentially being prosecuted for being a woman. That's abhorrent. I don't think the court should allow that to stand. Finally, I would suggest that if the local ordinance were within the gamut of what the legislature allowed Gilford to do, the regulation where it suggests their authority specifically mentions some exceptions, and the New Hampshire Supreme Court said exceptions are constitutional issues. I suggest that 354A, again, the law against discrimination, specifically overrides this statute. It's dealing with gender and sex in an unlawful way.
Overrides their ordinance.
It preempts this. Yeah, it preempts it. So the statute says, unless otherwise prohibited by law, this is a law, it's prohibiting the statute. If Gilford wanted to have a statute saying, no Asian people at our public beach, I don't think the court would think twice about striking down that statute. This is the exact same thing. The defendants, they were prosecuted for being female and public accommodations at Gilford Beach. So we'd ask that the court find the statute unconstitutional on its face and apply.
How is the prohibition from Asian people enjoying the beach and this set of circumstances parallel? I don't get that.
So,
in one case, you're prohibiting a race from even being there. In this case, the prohibition is in regards to attire. It's not in regards to gender.
Well, if the statute said black people have to wear a shirt at the beach and white people don't, the court would hesitate that too. In regards to whether there's a difference between race and gender, I would suggest under the New Hampshire Constitution, there's not. Still gets strict scrutiny, and it's just, there's no exception built in the statute. The legislature could have said, unless there's a legitimate reason, whatever language they wanted to use in regards to that sex, but there's just no built-in exception. That's what the state's looking for. They're looking for an exception. And I suggest it's not there, it can't be there to be constitutional. So we ask that the charges against them be dismissed, and that the court find the statute unconstitutional. Specifically, we are only objecting to the language in the statute as it deals with female topless sunbathing, not anything else.
Okay.
Thank you. Mr.
Berger.
Thank you, Your Honor. The state has submitted an objection, as it states in the conclusion, the purpose of the
regulations to promote safety and orderly use of the town beach. There is not a denial of access to public accommodations. There is a rule that requires that women wear a top when they're at Gilford Beach. State RSAs, specifically 644.9, violation of privacy, treat the male and female breasts differently. Quote, any device for the purpose of observing, photographing, recording, amplifying, broadcasting in any way or transmitting images or sounds of private body parts of a person, including the genitalia, buttocks, or female breasts. The legislature has this in place. It does not describe the male breast. They specifically are saying the female breast. So what I'm hearing from council is that if the town ordinance is discriminatory based upon the female breast, then RSA 644.9 must be as well, because it's prohibiting photographing of the female breast specifically. What this is about, Your Honor, you've heard testimony from the three state's witnesses, and it's societal standards for expectations. There's an expectation that a parent should be able to send their child to the beach without having to encounter topless females. They're not saying based upon age or anything else. It is across the board that Gilford does not want that standard here at Gilford Beach. As you heard from defense witness, when asked why she wouldn't walk down the street doing that, there's no need to. She doesn't desire the need. Laws and rules are put in place when people create the need. In this case, the town of Gilford either dealt with or foresaw this issue and decided we don't want this at Gilford Beach. With respect to 354A, that is in the trade and commerce. And again, the town of Gilford does not feel that they have been denied access. There are rules, they just need to adhere to them. Many of the issues that you're hearing today have already been litigated. Specifically,
may I approach that?
Sure. With respect to paragraph 28 of my objection, where the state reserves a right for further argument, the state would ask you to take into consideration the arguments in state of New Jersey, the Arlene Volt, V-O-G-T, June 25th, 2001. Many of the issues in this specific case, she was cited or ticketed for appearing topless at a public bathing beach as well. With respect to the status of the ordinance, it was argued that the ordinance denied equal protection under the Fourth Amendment of the United States Constitution because it distinguished legal and illegal conduct on the basis of gender. They also argued that the ordinance denied equal protection under Article 1, Paragraph 1 of the state constitution because of the individual rights it affects outweighed the asserted governmental interest it serves. That was shot down. She was found guilty of the underlying charges. It was went all the way up to the New Jersey Supreme Court and conviction held. Also, it addresses protecting the public sensibilities as an important governmental interest based upon indisputable differences between the sexes. Further, the prohibition against females bearing their breasts in public, although not offensive to everyone, as shown by the testimony in that case, three witnesses, it still seems socially as unpalatable. Therefore, the ordinance did not violate the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment. On restrictions to the exposure of the female breasts, they're supported by the important governmental interest in safeguarding the public's moral sensibilities, and the ordinance is substantially related to that interest. Hence, the ordinance satisfied both the federal and state test for equal protection. Your Honor, the state can go on and on. I've highlighted sections of this, so I would ask that the court to take into consideration, along with RSA 644.9, paragraph 1A and paragraph 2, in which there is distinction in the female breast. The state feels that it has met the burden and that they were topless and did violate the town ordinance. The town ordinance should remain as it is written.
Okay. Here, if I can just briefly respond to the case.
You can.
This case, looking over very briefly, they're applying the intermediate level of scrutiny under the federal constitution. Again, I would suggest under state constitution, it's not applicable. And second, in this case, when New Hampshire is specifically passing a statute saying that dealing with moral health and safety is not then flipping, so that's what I suggest.
What was the last one?
Essentially, the state, again, the law against discrimination has preempted the state's argument that they're protecting society. When the statute says to protect society, you treat them the same. Thank you.
Mr. Bradbury, last shot.
Nothing for that.
Okay. All right, folks. Ladies, the court will get back to you eventually here, and we're going to attend you, and we'll go from there. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you, Your Honor. You're
We're here outside the courtroom with Dan Hynes, attorney in this case. Dan, I thought it was really interesting approach asking about how people could determine who is female. Any comments on that approach?
Yeah, I mean, specifically for Barbara, as you heard, or yeah, from the testimony today, she doesn't associate as female. I think that's an issue. Gender and sex, I mean, it's not often a on-off sort of male-female thing. And people can associate, there's a lot of different ways that people can associate when it. So when it comes to sex and gender, I think it's unfair to treat everyone a certain way. So in Barbara's case specifically, I mean, that's why she's involved with this, her testimony, and it's important to her. So I mean, that is a potential issue. I'm hopeful that the court doesn't say, well, only people who may not identify as female are protected under statute. I think that would lead to a potentially unfair result that only certain people get protection in statute. So ideally, I hope the judge would strike it down on the sex grounds and just say that they either have to ban everyone or no one. It's not this middle ground or anything like that.
And this is basically an illegal ordinance by your argument, right? I mean, essentially, the state of New Hampshire hasn't outlawed toplessness by women, and so therefore the town of Gilford shouldn't have any ability to do that by no home rule, correct?
Well, there are two different arguments. So, yes. The second is, if there were to be an ordinance on the state level, I would think that's unconstitutional.
Sure.
So on the local level, it still would be unconstitutional in my opinion, but it also violates other state ordinances, one not expressly giving them that authority. And the authority they did give, it had exceptions to it. And I think when the exception says when prohibited by other law, not just the law against discrimination expressly prohibits that type of statute ordinance.
I think you made some good arguments today. Are you prepared to go to the Supreme Court if necessary on this matter?
Thank you. That'll be up to my clients whether they want to pursue that, but I'm hopeful for a favorable decision. It won't have to go that far. It would be nice to, I mean, this decision would go far. So presently there's a bill in the legislature attempting to ban female toplessness. I think that statute as well would be unconstitutional.
Yeah, hopefully that'll go nowhere and, fast.
Well, and I mean, I would love to testify. I often go to testify on bills. And if I go there with an order saying, hey, this judge found your statute unconstitutional, I might at least give him pause. So certainly a step in the right direction.
All right, great. Thanks, Dan. Great job.
Great, thank you.
Yep.
We're here outside the courthouse with Heidi Lilley. Heidi, thanks for coming on here today. And thanks for standing up for what you believe in.
Thanks.
It's refreshing to see people do that.
It's awesome.
And so you were one of the organizers of Free the Nipple, correct?
Yeah, Kia started it here in New Hampshire, and she dragged me along.
And there were several people out on the day that you were arrested. I learned this in court today.
There were six or seven of us here in Gilford Beach.
Why do you think only you and Liz were targeted for
They asked us who wanted to be cited, and three of us said, sure.
Okay, so you could have actually gotten out of it in that case.
Oh, yeah.
Then.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So you went ahead with this, two citations, you and Liz, and now the judge has taken it under advisement. What are you hoping for here today?
We're hoping for dismissal.
You're hoping what?
That he dismisses it.
And maybe overturns it as unconstitutional.
Exactly.
Too, right?
Absolutely.
So if he doesn't and rules in favor of the state, do you think you're going to
go
appeal?
To Supreme.
You will be going to the Supreme Court.
Yeah.
All right, fantastic.
I will.
Now, I thought it was interesting, Dan's questioning about how do you prove someone is female? How do you know that someone is female?
How do you?
Did the police ever examine your genitalia
No,
on the day in question?
Absolutely not.
So in theory, then, they really didn't have any proof beyond their hunch that you were a female. Correct?
All they had was our breasts to go by.
Yeah, that doesn't seem like real evidence, right? Because some men have, you know, big breasts.
And a lot of men have big breasts.
Yeah. I thought that would have been another interesting approach. It didn't go that way, but if he hadn't called you to the stand, then they wouldn't have been able to cross-examine and ask you about whether you're female or not. So he could have asked the police, well, did you examine Ms. Lilley's genitalia? And they would have said no, which would have been reasonable doubt and could have probably got the case kicked out in that case. So I thought it was really interesting. Thank you so much for being here and doing what you do.
Yeah. Really glad to meet you.
We'll be following along, and if it goes to the Supreme Court, I'll be there to report
and
that too.
You got to be voting for the bill that goes through, that doesn't go through. You've heard about that, haven't you?
What's this now?
This bill that's been written, put together to go to before legislature.
One of the state reps.
Yeah.
I'm not a state representative, so I won't have a chance to vote.
Well, you gotta be writing to your state reps to vote against.
If I get the chance, I'll probably be there to testify about I'm frequently at the state house testifying on a variety of different things.
So
hopefully I'll see you again there.
Turn that thing off. Thank you.
Thanks.
We'd like to invite you to visit freekeen.com. Freekeen.com features audio, video, and blogs chronicling the transition to a voluntary society. Freekeen.com also has comments and discussion forums so you can be heard. Freekeen.com.
I should be in Keene, New Hampshire with the Free Staters.